Alright, and here we are. Would like to play first. Sand seems really good. Temple into Reborg is just ideal. Another dissolve cannot hurt. Unless we're playing into mono red. Don't need the second day with this hand. Alright. And that just might be the game. We have two dissolves, a downfall, a dig, and a temple of silence, so. Two dissolves, a downfall, a dig. Turn. Opponent played their land for the turn. So I'm gonna downfall that end of turn. Alright, let's scry. We'll bottom that. Don't really need another land right now. I'll go ahead and dissolve that. I want to protect my dig. And this invocation can deal with whatever my opponent plays. I said we don't need another land, but a blue source and a scry land? Yeah, I'll keep it. Land number 6 is pretty good. On my face, turn to plaster. Alright, we're going to set a stop at our opponent's draw step. I'll bottom that. We definitely don't need a 7th land, even if it is a fetch. We're in a... hold up. Dissolve. It's okay if our opponent gets one land off of course. Wow, passing turn. Alright, well that's... Now we're gonna... Invocation. Opponent didn't want to play into counter magic, but... Invocation is really sweet. Sadabzan Charm? It is? That's fine. End hostilities and something else. I don't think I can commit Silumgar to the table just yet. Of course you're fine. Alright. Time to dig. I think I want the other dig and another end. All And I can just chain digs if my opponent doesn't do anything. If I draw a land though, I can utter an enforcer. And still dissolve up, so alright. Seems good. Opponent has Tassiger, land. Both Tassiger, Utter End, and Hostilities. Don't want them to get that land draw. Alright, they're gonna cast. When do they cast? That's fine. I just can't let Tassiger resolve in this situation. It just seems really bad. Okay. Seems alright. If they cast Tassiger, I can solve. If they don't cast Tassiger, I'll just take your time. Courser staying in play is not a huge issue. That's fine. I want to find a Wrath, but... Alright, let's take. What do we have? My eyes just hurt my brain, but will it seem the same? Come tomorrow, will I be older? Scorn is a hard counter. Maybe a soldier. And I want Downfall. May I be bolder than today? Now. Alright, that's good. We have two hard counters and Downfall. Alright, that's fine. Yeah, taking two is fine. Opponent is being extremely patient about not playing any counter spells here. We'll bottom the land. I'm gonna wait on Silumgar. Hold up my two counter spells. Here's Tassiger, which will be countered, and CTC, which will also be countered. Yes. That's a good one. Resolve, Hexproof, Dragonlord, Ojutai. It's fine. Opponent can play a land. Ojutai, Brick Walls, Courser. And... other things as well. but it gets me card advantage. Can't deal with Rhino plus Courser. Opponent has Utter Ends in hand that we know about, but okay, drawing Soul of the Earth works. Alright, let me connect. Excellent. Oh, command. Wow. Alright. How much mana do I have? Nah, I think I have to hold up Silmarillion Scorn and Energize again. Opponent has End Hostilities. I have Utter Ends. Okay, I'm going to counter that. Cast Utter End. Oh, I should have used Bile Blight to counter the Abzan Charm. That was really bad. Okay. That would have been really good. Jeez, I didn't even think of that, but that would have been huge. Ultimate price is fine draw. Take care of the Courser. Oh wow, I can't cast Ogitize Command. Yeah, we're not doing that. And kill it dead. That's where the bob light's going. Or we have another Ojitai. Oh, that just brick walls the Sorin. And we have exactly enough mana for Ojitai and Ojitai's command. Seems good. Yeah, we can kill Sorin. Opponent has Murderous Cut and Hero's Downfall. I'm gonna go ahead and dig through time. Bile Blight resolves. Alright, so opponent has Downfall, Sidisi, and I think a Rhino left. And that's fine. I just got a 3-for-1. Alright, what do I want? Oh no, they have the End Hostilities, sorry. So they have Downfall, Sidisi, and End Hostilities. Well, I don't want to run a Narset into a Downfall. So I still grab Ojutai and a Downfall of my own to deal with the Sorin. And that fizzles. I guess I'll play a replacement Ojutai. Sidisi can tutor up whatever she wants. Don't really have an issue with that. Alright, Rhino is fine. Okay, opponent has Sidisi, Downfall, and... Alright, well that works. We'll Crux. Destroy all non-dragon creatures. 4. 5. Gotcha. We have enough for Ojutai's command. And then I'm not going to attack. Sure. So we're actually in just a fine position here. Oh wow, play Silumgar with 2 counterspells up. 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay, 1 counterspell up. But drawing Dissolve is excellent. Because now we can Dissolve. We don't have to worry about Sidisi tutoring anything nasty up. But we can also dissolve whatever Sidisi tutors up. So I'll let them exploit Sidisi if they would like to. Oh. Yeah, that was a mistake. I was thinking that they would definitely exploit. But they don't have to. So I'm out of Ojutai's. I absolutely have to win with this Silumgar. Whoops. Come on, what's going on? Hello? Or shut. Oh. Okay. So I have to... gain 4 and draw a card. I should have attacked with Salumgar. But anyway, sorry about that, we're back. I should have attacked with Salumgar... because he's absolutely necessary for me to win this. And we're dead. Alright. Gonna bring in Prerogative. Command, Outer Ends, Negates, and Thoughtseize. Can take out the Blights. Everything else I think is fine. Crux of Fate is not great. Invocation is not that good. And negate or command might not be that good. It is a 2-for-1 and the opponent's deck is pretty slow though. Maybe we just don't want Thought Seizes. Yeah. I think we don't want Thought Seizes and we don't want the one Salumgar. We'll do that. I should have countered the CDC. 100%. That would have been... that would have left us in such a better position. But... we still... this is still going right. Okay. Yeah, anyways. Sorry for the technical difficulties. But... I didn't want to just... abandon this match. Because it was a really... it's really interesting so far. It's definitely nice, and it's a nice change of pace from the mono red matches. So, yeah, if only I'd countered. I made multiple small errors in that game, and it's crazy. Like, the deck is really good. I'll keep this. So the deck is really good, but it's really difficult to play. I mean, like all control decks. Right, that's a land. We'll keep that on top. Hopefully we can find a white source soon. I have to bottom her. We just have to hit our land drops. Is this a Thoughtseize or a Duress? No, they have one. Oh, wow. Another Narset. Ugh. We're gonna dissolve instead of negate this turn if we get the option. Which we could scry, but... alright. So now I just need a white source. Well, that's fine. I'll negate that. Don't want my opponent to clear the way for a Siege Rhino. Which appears to be exactly what they're casting. I'm gonna go get a swamp. And we're going to dissolve that. I need a white land. Well, prerogative is pretty sweet. So hopefully I can find my land. Lion is alright. Draw four. Wow, okay. Well, none of these are going to help me with Fleece Mane Lion. But... guess we'll dig for... a downfall. Nope. I will pick up a Caves of Koilos, though. And I guess... an Anticipate, maybe? Yeah. And we'll put everything else on the bottom. I'll pitch one of the other ends. I'm fine playing Drago with this Lion for a little while, considering I can't anticipate end of turn. Fire this off. Yeah, I'll go with Dragon Lord. That seems good. So, I have enough mana. Dragon Lord can block for Fleece Mane, can block Fleece Mane Lion, which forces my opponent to either stop attacking or attempt Monstrous. And if they attempt Monstrous, can respond with Utter End. Utter End the cat in response. Then I'm pretty much fine with whatever they take, because no matter what, I end up with a counterspell and some source of card advantage. I take the dig. Soren. So I have five. Alright. So I have nine mana. which is exactly what I need to cast Narset and activate two others. Alright, we're going to keep Scorn on top. And then Ojutai is going to attack Sorin. Kill it. Then we're going to cast Narset. And plus one for Scorn. Yes. Excellent. Oh wow, I need to start playing more quickly because we're down on time. So we have Scorn plus Dissolve. Oh, excuse me. Opponent's not getting anything done this game. And we have an Ojutai. Attacks me. I'm gonna go ahead and dissolve that, actually. We can basically start throwing spells everywhere because we have Narset plus Ojutai. And that lets us generate so much more card advantage over the long game than our opponent. Downfall is actually fine because we have to have some way to get this vampire off the table. I suppose we can race it. Yeah, we're a turn ahead. Alright, well, I'll take a dig through time. That seems really good. And then I will rebound to dig through time. We'll negate the downfall. And I'm gonna dig through time. So this is the big play. Dig, rebound, dig. Ooh, beautiful. Okay. So what do we want? We definitely want the Slumgar Scorn. And I'm pretty sure we want the Ojutai's command. Let's just cast multiple spells in a turn. Yeah. And we're killing our opponent in 3 attacks. Opponent's killing us in 4. So I think that's game. We can also gain 4 life with Ojutai's command if we need to. So again, this is a Tasigur, definitely getting hit with Ojutai's command. I'm gonna gain 4 life and counter it. I really don't need the card advantage. Dig is rebounding next turn. But this makes sure that we can win the race without having to expend additional resources to do so. Courser is fine. Because we get to downfall it. And we can indeed expend additional resources if our opponent is not in a position to answer the Dragon Lord. Alright. Rebound. MTGO is asking me if I would like to cast Dig Through Time. That's a very interesting question. I don't think I'll ever say no to that. Well, I'll pick up Scorn and Dissolve, I guess, and not lose this game ever. Alright, let's fire off the Thoughtseize. Abzan Charm and Tassiger. I'll grab the Charm. It's the only one that gives my opponent more options. Look at the top. Oh, I should have attacked the Dragon Lord first. It's just a little thing. I have 4 counter spells in hand and can cast 3 of them next turn. But yeah, stuff like that. So we'll take the temple. But I should have attacked first. Those 3 would have gone to the bottom. I would have gotten a fresh look. And I would have hit. We can bottom that. Don't need it. Opponent draws a land. Excellent. Welp. That would be game, folks. No thanks. Don't want Tassiger happening. And we attack first. Trigger. I will take, I guess, the downfall. We'll plus 1 Narset. I will reveal dissolve. We'll downfall this vampire for good measure. Alright, game 3. Now that we know our opponent has Fleece Mane Lions, I think we want Invocations. And we can get an Invocation over an Ultimate Price and a Hero's Downfall. Also, because we're on the draw, I think we want the Thoughtseize over the last Hero's Downfall. We'll go ahead and submit that. This deck post-sideboard is really smooth. Oh wow, jeez. Also, Dragon Lord Ojutai is bonkers. Yeah, we'll keep. Alright, land or nothing. Land or bottom. Bottom. Dress. Probably takes the Scorn, but maybe the Dissolve. They're not going to take anything else. I suspect the Scorn is the pick. Dissolve, okay. That tells me they don't really have very much to cast over the next, like, next turn. That's fine, it's a land. They're settling in for the long game, and they're accepting that if I'm gonna counter something, they don't want me to get the Scry out of it. That's pretty good. What are we casting? Yeah, we'll swarm that. I'm gonna scry one. Make sure we hit Ojutai next turn. Temple of Deceit is not great. We'll bottom it. Courser. Sure thing. Alright. I'm gonna jam Ojutai. And I'm not gonna block Courser when it attacks because I know my opponent has Abzan Charm. Alright, Windswept Teeth comes into play. Elsbeth would be a nightmare right now. Oh no, okay. Opponent is just playing Courser, getting the extra value out of the Windswept Teeth kind of thing. Not bad, not bad. Shuffle away the Sorin. Sure. No blocks. Alright, well, I'm going to go ahead and attack. I have two negates, so can do all sorts of things. Alright. And Narset seems pretty good. We're not going to play her just this moment. Because I want to protect this Dragon Lord. But after I use the negates, like, I'm going to have to double negate. I'm going to have to negate the downfall, or negate the Abzan Charm, and then negate the downfall. If I tap out for Narset, things don't go that way. Okay, opponent draws two. That is alright. Only, you know, only a certain subset of their cards matters right now. Although, double Courser does a pretty decent job of racing Ojutai. I will say no to that. Well, yeah, well, no, sir. Opponent can't cast their Abzan Charm that they drew. Have another downfall. We will negate again. Excellent. What's on top? Can't cast it this turn, but we'll still Narset into it. Black, white, blue. Yep. Top three. And I will grab an untapped blue source, I think. Yeah. Both at me. Interesting. They have Abzan Charm plus Hero's Downfall. I don't really know the last card in their hand. Yep. That's unfortunate. Oh, wow. Okay, that's fine. So they have Rhino, Read the Bones, and I don't know what else. I'm going to go ahead and rebound. I will take care of one of the coursers. White one. Opponent draws two, which is fine. Alright, so their hand is Temple of Malady and Sea Rhino and Read the Bones. And I can't counter. Oh no. Temple, Sea Rhino, Read the Bones. So they're gonna Thoughtseize first. I think I have to dissolve that. Yeah. I wanna set up the top card of my library. Invocation is solid. I have to deal with the courser somehow. Still attacking me. That seems weird. Alright, are we reading the bones? Yes. But I get to see the cards. Duress and Thoughtseize. Alright, only one of those is going to be relevant. I think. They are holding onto the Siege Rhino, though. Alright, well, we'll take care of that guy. And I'll plus one. Yes. That seems amazing. All right, I have to find a dragon. Or dig and Thoughtseize. Alright, I'm gonna fire up Thoughtseize. I'm unlikely to win this just because of the time situation. I'm taking my opponent's Thoughtseize. So they have Rhino and Temple. I don't know what they're doing now. Oh well. Gotta dig. They drew a Thoughtseize, which was very good. Guess I'll get Anticipate and Ojitai's Command. And we'll see what opponent takes. Alright. I just need an answer to the Rhino. Then I'm winning this game on board. Alright, so we have Downfall, which is what we needed. And opponent has a temple. And I'm going to... Actually, we're going to rebound anticipate. And we'll get a... We'll get a command. Ship the turn. We are going to lose on time, but that's fine. You guys saw how the match played out. We're in extremely good position. Alright, Dragon Lord. Might actually be able to win this. Counter target creature, spell, draw a card. Oh, I should have gained 4 life. Now I'm dead to Siege Rhino. Okay. Yeah, I'm dead to Siege Rhino. Nothing I can do, so I totally should have gained 4. But... if I weren't in a rush, I definitely would have found that line. Alright, I'm not winning. Not winning in time. I might, actually. Oh yeah, 1 attack. Opponent's just dead. Okay, never mind. Thought it was gonna take 2. I thought this was 3 power. We got there. Whew. Alright, well, that's actually a great spot to wrap up the video series. Kind of a very climactic. This is a great, great match. Alright, thanks for watching. And I might do a write-up, like an article on this deck, depending on if I stick with it or not. So, we'll see. Definitely, it's definitely really good. So, thanks for watching.